Hey guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'm sat with Jonathan Graham.
I'm here.
Yeah, and we're taking a look at Positive Grid Bias Amp 2. And this is the first time you've looked at this, isn't it?
It is the first time. I mean, I've heard great things about it. You've been telling me about it. I've played a little bit with the bias effects. But of course, this is a whole different beast, isn't it?
It's a lot deeper than bias effects. What this essentially is you might think about it as an amp modeler, but rather than coming from the outside in and trying to capture an amp that already exists in the real world, this is coming at it from the inside out. So you're trying to basically go in and piece together an amp that fits your playing style and your tonal preferences from parts. So what I wanted to do was take on the challenge, because I know how picky you are about tones and feel, and as we all are, rightly so. Yeah,
it's got to be right, hasn't it? You know?
Yeah, totally, man. Well, no, it has to. Otherwise, you know, we walk into a guitar shop and go, an amp, please. Yep. So, you know, an amp for me.
And also, yeah, as well, in particular with this type of software and other things that are on the market, you know, people are shying away from this sort of thing because they feel sometimes that the natural feel isn't there than what they'd be getting an amp. But from what I've been hearing so far, this thing is a real answer to that.
It's pretty good, man. It's pretty good, isn't it? But again, natural feel means different things to different people.
Yeah.
You know, so the beautiful thing about this is it's not just a case of finding, you know, finding an amp that you like. It's tailoring you know, an existing amp construct, or even just building one from the ground up, just tailoring it so it's absolutely perfect for you. And that's what we're going to do now. So we're going to take on the challenge building John an amp for the day. Question is, what do you want?
Yeah, well, I mean, that is the million-dollar question, isn't it? I mean, this is why we end up with huge guitar and amplifier collections. I mean, so lead tone-wise, we're talking here.
We can do lead tone.
I don't know. I mean, maybe. I mean, I really, you know, I dig my Bogners. I also really like the Cornford kind of sound. I mean, they're quite different. I mean, it's something that's got, you know, a nice singing lead tone. Maybe something that's a little rubbery upper mids. You know, that
okay,
type of thing.
Yeah.
I don't know. Can we do that?
We can definitely do that. So what I'm going to do is now you give me some models to go from there.
Okay.
I'm going to get you just to play. And don't pay too much attention to what I'm doing. I'm going to flick through some presets, and we're going to start by finding something that you just instinctively go, yeah, that's close. There's something I like about that. Don't worry about it getting exactly right, because we'll get to that.
Okay.
But yeah, if you just want to play, I'll flick through and stop me when we find something that speaks to you.
All right, let's go for it then. Off, but I dig it.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah, I'm thinking that's cool.
So we've kind of found like a nugget of an amp that you like there. Obviously, it's not where you want it to be.
No.
But let's start with what you do like about it.
Okay.
So what is it that you dig about that sound?
Well, I'm really liking the kind of bite to the tone, you know.
Okay.
It's you know, I don't know whether this is something that necessarily can be quantified in this, but it's very responsive. I mean, I think that says a lot about software, doesn't it? And you know, even though it is quite away from what I'd said, I would use this lead tone. That's,
okay,
that's pretty cool.
Well, let's see if we can massage this and get it a little closer to where it's meant to be. So what I'm going to do is we'll begin with what's essentially kind of a top-down approach to constructing this. What that essentially means is we have, you might think of this as almost like a signal flow. So if we start here with the preamp, that feeds through, there's an optional EQ stage, we'll not worry about that, feeds through into the tone stack, and then into the power amp, finally the transformer, the cab, any EQ that we have post. And then if we have an amp match feature on there as well, which in this instance is not engaged, that's fine, we'll leave that be, that's fine. That's another story for another day. What we'll do is we'll start at the top end. I'm going to leave that EQ curve where it is because that's pretty gentle. It's just a little bit of high and low roll off. We'll start at the cab because the further towards this end of the spectrum things are, the more of a difference it makes to the sound.
Sure.
Whereas stuff at this end is a little more, it's more about the feel, if you know what I mean, and we'll address that in a moment. So in terms of the actual tone, you like the bite, but I feel like the sound itself is a little bit, perhaps nasal.
It is, the frequencies are a little bit different. I mean, I think, I would imagine that you're wanting to push more upper mids as opposed to where this seems a bit more toppy than high mids.
Let's start with the mic in that case. Okay. Then. So my first instinct is to switch this out for a Royal 121, which is going to smooth out all of those kind of obnoxious high frequencies. Mm. If you just play me just a couple of phrases on the 57. And then we compare that to this.
Quite a bit different.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm now that I'm hearing that, you know, I'm thinking, do I like that better or not? But that's not really the point of this right now.
No,
we're trying to replicate.
What about if we have both? So what about if we throw a 57 in there as well? So let's play with that. And I'm just going to shift this around a little bit.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Yeah. If you play, I'll move it.
Cool. Yeah,
that's a lot. That's kind of got the best of both worlds. So we've got the bite from the 57, we have the warmth from the Roya. Let's actually select a cab model as well, because at the minute we're using tread plate cab, which is like a Mesa 4x12.
Okay.
But there's a whole load of cabs that we can have in here. You would sort of expect probably vintage 30s, I would imagine.
I'm at home, what I have generally is my Vintage 30 and a greenback. I have them mixed together in a 2x12. So,
that's interesting.
So I don't know whether, you know, a Vintage 30 would probably be the one that I would be more likely to mic up, though.
That makes a lot of sense.
So
why don't we try a couple of these then? So maybe if we had, I'll tell you what. Yeah, here's some V30s. Let's see how this behaves.
Yeah.
But what about this?
I'm digging that.
You dig it? Yeah. That's Eminence Legends.
Right,
you typically associate with the Soldano SLO.
Right.
But no, it's all good.
It makes it a bit more aggressive.
I think so.
Yeah.
There's a bit more something going on. Mm. So anyway, so we're going to skip the power amp and the transformer just for now. Mm. Everybody seems to kind of obsess over the output valves in an amp. So at the minute we've got 6L6s. There's a whole bunch we can choose from. We're not going to get too far into that yet, but we will address that. I just want to have a look at the tone stack because everything goes through the tone stack on an amplifier, and it really does affect the frequency response of what we got going on here. So at the minute, it's German Fireball. I'm gonna switch that out for, just as a guess, I'm gonna switch it out for either British Crunch or British Modern. Let's start with Crunch.
Okay.
If you just play, I'll switch it out as you're playing.
Sure.
And you just give me your feedback on that.
Let me hear the other one again.
Yeah, well, let's go back to... Let's try this one. Let's try British Modern.
Okay.
Yeah. So what we've essentially done there is we've taken was basically an angle-derived amp.
Right.
We've ripped out the tone stack and put a modern Marshall tone stack in its place. Mm-hmm. And we've also run it through the cab that you'd expect to hear with a Soldano SLO. Mm-hmm. So we're really starting to kind of hybridize things here. We'll come back to the feel. Okay. Let's just do a little bit on the transformer. Because at the moment we have a British style transformer, but your transformer makes a huge difference to the kind of the low end response and the sort of the general aggressiveness of the amp.
Right.
So I'm gonna try a few, and you just tell me what you like the sound of a little better. So if you wanna play.
I do think that last one, I mean, it was quite difficult to tell because you're really splitting hairs on it with that sort of thing. Obviously, it does make a difference, but the overall tone itself seems to already be kind of built in. So they all sound great. It's just how big or, you know, that you want it to make. But I think the last one I was liking the most.
Yeah, this fella here. Well, that's the fast style one.
I think so. I would have taken all of them, to be honest.
Oh, yeah, of course, man. Yeah, but in terms of the rubberiness, this one's going to give you... give you that kind of rubbery feel where it's really kind of you know, the low end is very fat and very bouncy, and it's called fat style. But other things we can do with this is we can play with the compression.
Okay.
So if I turn the transformer compression down and you just have a little play.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah, if I turn it up. Liked it off. Great. Okay, that's cool. Well, there's something we've learned. So, and you know, you would never have had this opportunity.
No.
Yeah. If you were just playing with an amp, you get what you get.
Yeah.
I mean, you can manipulate it based on how, you know, how big the, you know, how hard you hit the transformer.
That's it.
But that's
and
pretty
we've only
it.
Spent, you know,
couple
not
minutes.
Not yeah, we've not spent long on it.
Let's get to. Should we do the power amp? Let's do the power amp.
Okay.
Why not? We'll do very, very quickly. We'll leave it at push-pull, because I don't think there's much point going Class A with this sort of thing. There's a couple of different 6L6 types we can play with.
I mean, normally, obviously, knowing what I know is in these amps that I tend to really dig, I mean, I like 6L6s a lot, but they do tend to have EL34s in there.
Oh, okay. Well, let's try. We had this, just for the sake of it being. I'll switch to EL34s as you go.
Okay.
See if you like it.
Not as much.
Okay. What don't you like about it?
I feel like the gain changed. I feel like the gain changed quite a bit.
With this kind of amp, the power section is providing quite a lot of the gain.
It's ended up feeling like it's not as tight a sound as it was with the 6L6s.
Let's try this.
You changed that at the end. I really like that.
That was literally back to step one.
Okay.
So that's okay. So that means we were right in the first place. Last step really is to go to the preamp, and this is where things get a little interesting because you can pre and post emphasize things on the preamp, and it's actually the pre-emphasis that I want to get to first. But before we do anything, do you feel like we have enough gain on the go there?
I think so.
Good.
Yeah.
I would hope so, because there's a lot.
You would... Obviously, when you're working with this thing on your own, you're going to experiment. Sometimes you want a bit more gain, but it feels enough to move.
Yeah, I mean, you can access that from the front panel of the amp, so it's easy to turn it up and down. What I will do, though, there's a few little cut frequencies we can go with.
Okay.
So if you want to play, I can turn the high cut down, which will take some of the upper frequencies out.
Okay.
Thank you. But this bit is pretty interesting because this is the pre-emphasis. So what this essentially does, it's pre-EQ. It basically it determines what's going into the game. And this, for my money, is essentially why people like certain amps, why people don't like certain amps in terms of feel. Some people like a whole lot of low end going into the amp. Other people, like myself, don't like very much low end going in at all and like the low end to come later in the chain.
Right.
So what I'm going to do, knowing what I know about you, is I'm going to turn the low shelf going into the amp up and then I'll pull it out a little bit at the other end. So how do you feel about this?
I think, though, it's made it a little dark.
A little dark?
Yeah.
Well, let's push the high frequencies and the mids at the other end. So let's try that. That's great. So, I mean, all we've done there is we've literally, we've just driven more low end into the distortion, which fattens up the attack. It takes away a little bit of the kind of the scratch on the string kind of feeling.
Sure.
It makes the amp behave a little more slowly, if you know what I mean. It's not as kind of like right in the nose, like a plexi kind of job. It's a little more like a JTM 45.
Okay.
In that regard, obviously, it doesn't sound anything like that.
No, but, I think I think it's a good, interesting point. I mean, you are very particular about what you're after, and you're great at knowing what frequencies to find. And I think for most of us out there, we're still sort of struggling to find those things sometimes. Like we kind of get an idea of what we like, but for me there, I've been sidetracked because I had something in mind, but then I heard something else that I was digging, and then I was like, right, actually I want to go in this direction, which I think is a great use of this tool, because you know, you will probably find that you might discover a tone that you didn't even realize you wanted, and that's the way to go with it.
That's exactly it.
But the thing I'm most impressed by this is, this is software. I'm looking at a laptop right now, and I'm playing through that. I know we're actually going through the power cab, Yamaha's Line 6 power cab, which is, you know, a fantastic piece of gear as well, but it's making it sound great coming out there. But you could use this in the studio. All the stuff is happening in that software, and it sounds very, very natural. And more importantly, it feels it.
Yeah, that's it. It tracks the nuances of your playing very well, which is great. I mean, that's it, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? Fundamentally, it's making you play well. We've changed the tone that we like. And in terms of preconceptions for what you like and you don't like, I mean, we could tweak this for hours and get it absolutely perfect, but you know, we're not going to go as far as all that. But in terms of what you like, we started with kind of a preconceived idea of, I like Bogner, I like Cornford, which, understandably, awesome amps.
Yeah.
We shut our eyes, found a tone that was inspiring, and then massaged it in a way that was led by what you enjoy rather than, you know, what you think you're after. Do you know where I'm coming from? And what we've ended up with, who can say? Who could even say what this is? It's a Soldano cab with kind of a big fat style transformer with the power amp. The transformer's got almost no transformer compression. The power amp is from like an angle setup. The preamp, I know, right? The tone stack is from a modern Marshall. The preamp is kind of a tweaked version of what we had, but with more low-end pre-emphasis and less low-end post-emphasis. It's just totally different from what we ended up with. So that's what I'm going to do is I will, I'm going to save this, and how do we do that? Let's just do it up here, right? So I'm going to save it in Logic. Why not? So I'll save that as Bias Amp 2, and we'll just call it John Lead. Yeah?
Sounds good.
And what I'll do is I'm gonna pull up what we had, and then I'll load up John Lead, and you'll see where we ended up.
Okay.
So if we just go straight back to this fella, that's that edited version. So if we have that, this is what we came from. We'll be right back. I just fire up John Lead, we should get this. I think it sounds wicked. Most importantly, you know, you're playing great through it because it's driven by your preferences.
Yeah.
It's an amp built for you.
Yeah, well, I don't know about the great playing, but I'll take that. I'll take the compliments when they come. But no, it makes you want to play. It feels a little bit like that thing, like there's stuff that you know inspires you to play, doesn't it? You know what I mean? And that's what this is all about.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Interestingly as well, you know, if I was dialing a lead tone for myself, what's kind of interesting is I would really probably enjoy that sonically. Mm. Go, that's a great sounding lead tone. The feel would probably be very wrong for me, so I could go in and fill it with that myself. Mm. But that's another story for another day. We're not going to do it now.
Okay.
But if I could get you some more tones, what would you be after?
Well, we've looked at a lead tone there. I mean, I probably want something different for like some, you know, heavy riffage type stuff.
Okay.
I don't know, like some diesel type stuff. We'll keep the bar high, you know.
Yeah, absolutely, man. Well, the thing is, I mean, we say diesel, but you know, we said Bogner for this, and we've ended up with who knows what. So we'll have that in mind. And then we'll go from there. But that's maybe another story for another day. Yeah,
we'll do that next time for sure. But yeah, tons of fun with this thing. Bias Amp 2. Definitely go and check it out. I mean, where can the guys get this?
Well, you can get this straight from Bias. You know, you can go to the Positive Grid website and you can get hold of this. Download it. It's wicked. You can get it right now. You don't even have to leave your house.
Well, go and definitely check that. Fantastic
stuff. And of course, don't forget, if you get a tone that you dig and you wanted to take it on the road with you, you can just literally stick it into the Bias amps.
Of course.
You know, the head or the Bias Amp Mini, which is new. That's a fun thing. Mm-hmm. You can take it on the road with you. It's very cool. So who knows? Maybe we'll get a series of John's favorite tones. We'll put it in it. We'll put it in an amp.
Yeah. Well, then, I just want them for me. That's for sure. So
there you go.
You know,
but, jobs are good.
Fantastic.
Cool, man. Well, we'll do that again in the near future, I think.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching, and we will see you next time.